Hello, hello, friends, family, beautiful people of the United States of America. This is Elder Olson coming at you from the beautiful Curicó, Chile, Alameda Ward. It's a beautiful morning. Looking out the window here, we've got, well, I honestly can't see much because the sky's full of chimney smoke, but that's okay. It's still going to be a beautiful day for a barbecue, which I think is what we're going to be doing today. We're going to go have a farewell barbecue with one of our investigators because I'm leaving. I'm leaving Curicó. We got the transfers on Saturday night. We got them super late because the assistants changed the password to our account to all the zone leader accounts because a lot of zone leaders and other people try to get the transfers early, and so we ended up getting them super late. But it all worked out okay. So I will be leaving Curicó after just two changes here. I thought I'd be here a little longer, but that's okay. I'll be headed to Rancagua. A ward that's called Baquedano. And yeah, so I'll be there with Elder Davis. I'm going to be a zone leader again there, so that should be fun. Should be interesting. I hope we can do the same thing that we did here, because we had a ton of success here this last change. It was awesome. A lot of success in the sector, a lot of success in the zone. In the sector, we have at least two definite baptisms for the next change, and another two or three that are probable. So that'll be awesome. I'm kind of sad that I won't be able to see them, but I am really stoked that I'll be leaving here on a high note. So yeah, in this last week we've been teaching Roberto, who I think I mentioned him last week. He's an atheist who we found at 9:30 at night last Saturday, and then came to church on Sunday. And then we've been teaching him through the week, and he came to church again yesterday. And he's awesome. We've been teaching him. He's got a lot of questions, and he's really sincere with his questions. You get a lot of people who kind of just want to fight about philosophy or want a Bible bash or who knows, but he's really sincere, and he actually wants to know. And when we explain something and it makes sense to him, he's like, okay, yeah, that's cool, I understand that. And so that's been really cool, and we've seen some progress with him this week. He reads everything we give him. He reads it right away, and then he's like, yeah, I've got questions about, without even looking at the book, he's like, I've got questions about verse 27, verse 32 and 33, and he really understands what we're talking about. So that's not something that I'm used to. That's something that's awesome. I love that. And this week he prayed for the first time. I don't know if it was the first time in his life. I doubt it, but the first time with us. And we've invited him to pray before, and he's like, no, I'll read. I'll come to church to learn more, but I'm not going to pray to somebody who doesn't exist. And we talked a lot about faith, about that hope in things which aren't seen, which are true, and a lot about how action is part of that faith. Really, faith is everything, as far as missionary work is concerned. But so yeah, in this last lesson that we had with him, he committed. Well, we invited him to baptism, and he rejected us, but he did accept the invitation to pray at the end, and he didn't say he'd never be baptized, but he didn't accept a date. He accepted the kind of a lighter invitation, like if you pray and read, and you feel that these things are true, would you be baptized? And he said, and that's, yeah, if I think it's true, yeah, I'll be baptized. So it's something, but little bit at a time, despacito. I don't know if that song's super popular there. I think it would be because there's a Justin Bieber version that's going around here now as well. But that song's been really popular here for a while. Let's see. So yeah, that was awesome. And then what else has happened this week? This weekend we were doing some farewells. Last night more than anything, with one of the families that's been really really great to me here. It's the, or some of my good friends. This ward is one that I definitely want to visit again at some point, because it's been a lot of fun here, even though I've just had my short time. We had a good family home evening yesterday about with these converts about not being afraid to stand alone. We watched that video of President Monson and the Navy, which is awesome. Apart from that, so this change, we've had this goal. We had the goal of finding 7 new investigators each week, which, I mean, you can't compare it with other missions. I don't know if that's a lot or a little compared to other places, but here, that's a lot. That's not something that I've ever seen any sector do, and I've certainly never done, is find one new investigator for every day of the week for the change, or for the whole transfer. And we did it a week early. We ended up finding 13 in 1 week and 8 in another week, and so that made up an extra 7. So in week 5 we'd already met our goal, and that put us at 42 for the change. And we're like, all right, so we've got to find 8 in the next week instead of 7, because if we find just 7, we'll be 49 instead of 50, and it's just not as cool. You got to get 50. So we worked our butts off to get those new investigators this week, and we got to Sunday yesterday, and we only had 4. We had 4 news, and we were pretty, I don't know, I guess the word would be desperate. We were going everywhere we could think of finding to look for news. We contacted for a little while and nothing. We were passing by Futures and nobody was home. Everybody leaves their house on Sunday. And at the end of the day, it was literally like the last minute. We had an appointment for that family home evening at 8, and it was probably 7:45, 7:50 that we passed by this house with some Haitians that we'd passed by before, and we'd talked to some of them, and there are a couple that speak Spanish. I mean, even though I'm basically a pro at Creole, I'm not really actually that pro. It's pretty tough. I can introduce myself and tell them that I can speak a little bit of Creole, and that's it. But we got there and we start knocking on the door, and there's nobody there. And we call them, and they answer, but then the phone like cuts out, and we can't hear them. We have no idea where they're at. And so we called them a couple times, and nothing, and nobody's there. A young married couple there in that house with a bunch of other Haitians that live there as well. But the ones that we mainly talked to, who spoke better Spanish, is that young married couple. And right. So we've been knocking for about 5 minutes, and we're like, all right, you know, they're not going to come out, or they're not home. Sometimes they just don't hear. But we, before leaving, I said a silent prayer while my companion was on the phone and asked, like, please, we need these 4 news to meet our goal, and we know that it's possible and that you can help us. Like, please help. And right as I finished saying the prayer, they pulled up in a car, and they got dropped off. The young married couple got dropped off, and they're like, hey, yeah, come on in. And we went in, and inside there were two of their friends who were just kind of kicking around, not doing anything. And so we invited them to listen too, and then we had our 4. It was 4 exactly. Which was exactly what we needed to meet our goal. So that was cool. That was a nice little miracle that we had this week. We also had a ton of people in the sacrament meeting. I haven't had so many people in the sacrament meeting in my mission. We had a bunch of baptismal dates as well. It's been awesome. So yeah, that was pretty crazy. So I think that's about it for this week. I'm trying to think of anything else that's happened that's worth mentioning. Earlier in the week, my I broke one of my bike one of the axles for my back tire, my back wheel, and so we had to get that fixed because it was wobbling all over the place. And so we were on foot again for a little while, which is pretty. I don't know. it's a pretty long walk, even though it's we don't. It's not quite as far as in Buin it was to walk through the sector, but it's still pretty far. We actually live in another ward, not even in our own ward. But I can't think of anything else. But really, oh yeah. I wanted to share something that I read a little while ago, but I love it about goals and reaching your goals. And I really want to like testify of the power of goal setting. Because that was the way that we had so much success this change, was by setting these goals and saying we're not giving up until we get these goals. And it's a poem I found in, or I think, yeah, a poem that I found in one of the talks that I've read before. And it's called "If You Want a Thing Bad Enough." And it goes like this. If you want a thing bad enough to go out and fight for it, work day and night for it, give up your peace and your sleep and your time for it, if your only desire makes your aim higher, never to tire of it, if life seems all in empty and useless without it, and all that you dream and you scheme is about it, if gladly you'll sweat for it, fret for it, pray with all your strength for it, if you'll go after that thing that you want with all your capacity, strength, and sagacity, faith, hope, and confidence, stern pertinacity. If neither poverty nor pain, nor famished and gaunt, nor sickness or pain to body or brain can turn you away from that aim that you want, if dogged and grim you besiege and beset it, you'll get it. And really, that's true. I've always firmly believed in that if we want something bad enough, we'll get it. And it's really just a matter of becoming motivated enough to put in the work. Because it's really, no matter what it is, it's really just a matter of work and how much we're willing to give to achieve it. And that's especially true with missionary work or anything in the gospel, because, well, no, only when we have our will aligned with the will of God, and when when our desire is the same as God's desires, and we want what He wants, we will get it almost every time. God might try our patience; He might make us wait for it, or maybe we'll screw up, and that's okay. But really, when we have a righteous desire and we exercise faith to achieve that righteous desire, and it's according to the will of God, we will get it. And we can't make the excuse of, oh, maybe it just wasn't God's will, maybe it's just not what He wanted. If it's a righteous desire, we have to go at it with everything we've got. And that's when we will get it. And I'm really excited to be able to apply that in a new sector this change. I really hope that this change wasn't just a one-hit wonder, and that I'll get to this new sector and everything will just go to dirt. But I think that, well, really by applying this, that we'll have success there, and I'm super excited to have the chance to do that. So just want to let you all know that I love you, and that I think about you guys, and I pray for you, and I know the church is true. Read the scriptures, pray, go to church, do your family meetings, do everything you should do. Love you guys, take care, bye-bye.